Hi, I'm Li Hao. So in the last video, I shared about what is Svelte Actions, right? And some of you may ask, like, for example, you have a variable that you pass in as a params of the action, and you want to change that that parameters. And how will that reflect? How do you get that parameters be reflected in your action? Right, so probably a bit vague, but let me try to explain this to you with example in this REPL. So over here, you have an inputs box that is bind, the value of the inputs is bind to this variable called name. And I'm going to show name over here as well. So when I type in over here, say I change the world to Svelte, you can see the name changes to Svelte, right? And I'm using this name variable in this action called Lihao action, right? But this action is being only called once when this element is added to the DOM, right? And the destroy will be called when it's removed from the DOM, right? Okay. But I want this name variable to be always in sync with this action. Or put it the other way, I want this action to know that whenever this params change, I'm going to do something. Because in this example, in this action, I'm setting the inner HTML as the params, which is a string that I'm passing in. And it's only being called once when this DOM is this div is added to the DOM, which is when it's say world, when the value is world, right? But then when I change this variable, which is the params, I want to get notified as well, right? How do you do that? Well, actually, this object that you return, besides you can return a method called destroy, you can actually return another method called update. Right, and this update method will also will contains the new params, right? So this function will always be called whenever this params change, right? So update. I'm trying to say update and new params. I'm gonna show you over here, right? So I'm gonna change something. You're gonna see that update is being called with world one as I'm typing, right? So this way I can change it. I can use this and update my HTML if I want to, right? So I'm gonna come here and say this equals to new params, right? So whenever I change this inner HTML updates as well, right? That's cool, right? That's slick. So that you have it, right? So let me conclude it even more, even better, which is that an action is a function that will be called when your element is added to the DOM, right? You can pass in the parameters, which will be the second parameters to your action, right? If your action returns an object, and if that object has a method called update, that update method will be called every time when your params change. And if that return object contains a method called destroy, that method destroy method will be called when your element is removed from the DOM. Right, so any of updates or destroy or return object is optional. Right? Once if you have it, it'll be called. Right, so it's very simple. To use an action, you call a use directive. So use colon and the action name equals to parameter. Right, a parameter can be numbers, objects, and strings, and so on and so forth. Right, so that's about it in this video. So if you love to learn more about Svelte and actions, please be sure to subscribe to my channel, because in the next video, I'm going to share with you what are the use cases or what are the cool things you can do with Svelte Actions. See you in the next video. Bye bye.